Hi, I'm John Fung, and this is the video supplement to our review of BlazBlue Continuum Shift. The most immediate comparison that comes to mind with BlazBlue Continuum Shift is Super Street Fighter IV from earlier in the year. Both games are budget-priced updates of 2D fighting games released last year. Both games feature balance and system tweaks behind the scenes that will largely go unnoticed by people who aren't diehard fans. Both games feature some new gameplay modes, and both games update the roster with a helping of new characters. With BlazBlue, there are four new characters, though only three of them really count. Tsubaki is a young soldier ordered to hunt down two of the other characters for deserting their order, who meditates during battle to boost the power of her special moves. Hazama, the main villain of the first game, whoops, spoilers, is also playable this time around, using his magic Ouroboros snakes to pull in enemies and quickly move across the screen. There's also a console-exclusive character whose very existence is kind of a spoiler, and then there's Lambda 11, who really doesn't count so much as a new character, seeing as she's basically just another version of New 13 from the first game, only not quite so grossly overpowered, in theory. There are also a few characters waiting in the wings: Squirrel Girl Makoto, Multiple Personality Bounty Hunter Platinum the Trinity, and Werewolf Butler Valkenheim, but they won't be coming until the DLC is ready. All of the other elements are there from the first game. You have your standard arcade mode, you have the story mode where you occasionally take up the controller to fight, in between mostly static conversations that tell an utterly incomprehensible, yet still somehow entertaining story. There's also a mostly new tutorial mode that aims to teach complete newbies the basic skills and terminology needed in the game, and it actually works decently well, despite the narrator insulting you at every possible turn.
Does understanding yet elude you?
Some of the higher level lessons are a bit obtuse for all but the most determined, however. In the end, though, criticizing some of the new features and the story mode feels slightly pointless, because the core of BlazBlue is as stellar as it's always been. The behind-the-scenes improvements and balancing tweaks make for a smooth, fast-paced on-screen brawl. The new characters are fun to play as and every bit as unique and over-the-top in design and play as we come to expect from the franchise. And yes, the music still rocks your friggin' face off. I mean, where else are you gonna get to play as an evil green-haired Michael Jackson clone with the power of evil magic snakes? Rock Band? I don't think so. I think I have a letter to write to Harmonix.
I'll put 100% power.